Hi guys. So yes, we do have a new party member. No. Okay. Sure. We got the Luke. After I don't know how many pulls, finally got D-Loop. Alright, so let's do commissions. I want to see. Start with this one. I didn't realize Kaya's health was so low. Hold on. My dog is having like a freak attack over here, and I don't know why. Go heal everyone before we go to another commission. D-Luke's HP is only so low as I just got him. Like, I was taking a break from cleaning my house today. I'm like, you know what, I'll get on Genshin and do a pull. I did a few that were single and did on Sino's banner. And I guess I hit hard enough pity and I got Diluc. Oh, we're not too far.
Stabilize.
We'll need more where that came from.
Sure, dealer. Let's go. Chili and Okay, well, we can't get there. Where else? So let's just go to Leela. Is there anywhere over here? It's close.
I don't need an umbrella, but you can use one if you need.
Thank you. Oh! I think I'll be okay. Thank you very much, Julie. Whether it's much more suitable for Kaya.
Solidify.
There you are. Blink. Let me amuse myself a little.
Freeze.
Over here.
What's the hurt?
Cool it. Blink. There.
I'll keep this close.
Oh wow, that's pretty. Thank you. If we can't find him here in the next little while, we'll just go to Leela and buy some. I say that and then I find three. Cool. There was something else we needed. Bastards. They are. Some kind of meat, actually. Let's go to that restaurant in Leela. They might have it. Excuse me. Oh, the boar. I'll be right back, guys, okay? Thank you. Sorry, guys, a headache. Yes, I feel like you do. Just maybe a little worse. Okay, where are you? Sure, lady. Yay! Well, okay. We need to complete other stuff first. We're not terribly far, but let's make sure everybody's at full health. But this, in case it's. This is where it gets a little tough because we're doing daily commissions, then we have stuff in Liyue to do, and the event that's going on, so. Whew. Oh, it's another one of these chests. That's probably Kaya. Oh, that's Timmy. Okay, well, we'll do that in a little bit.
This is order.
Yeah.
Solidify. Verdict is... Gather! I will have order! Stabilize!
Maybe we'll do it in the third, but we will. I thought so.
Solidify.
Lisa said that the Knights of Avonius would help us get ingredients for Razor's wine, right? They should probably be ready by now.
Hi, Mom.
Let's go check.
Hi, Mom. Shut up. I'm going to run away from Hilly Trolls right now. But yes, I'm sure you're right. Gosh dang Heli Trolls.
Order guides you.
And in a bit. Hey, baby.
Stabilize.
Ad Astra Abyssosk.
Shut up.
Ad Astra Abyss. Thank you for completing today's.
To do that. Oh my goodness, your HP, girl. Let's go. I have to find all your stuff.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember.
Oh, but you can get more of yours.
But where are those?
Okay. Shush. Yeah, we gotta go back to Leela.
take part in the Knights of Favonius' charity event.
Why is it up there? The wrong way. Sit down, girly. So this was you. You went through a lot of trouble, buddy. Something about Cider Lake. Maybe the other side.
Can I also enjoy?
Liu is Archon?
Liu is Archon.
Something awful happened to him. I guess.
Have you heard? The strange wanderer from Wolvendom has shown up in Springvale.
When you're high up, everyone can hear your voice.
Okay, we're going to the festival.
Yeah.
Retribution!
Hunting stuff is getting old. forget, you gotta go here.
Nice to meet you. My... Everything's ready. Let's go!
In a place I don't even know about.
You should really bring the Knights of Favonius with you next time.
Headquarters, okay. That's where we have to go for Razor. Yeah, I know. Ooh. My god.
Paimon wonders how Razor's class has been going.
I've wondered and curious too.
Sucrose, wait! Honorary Knight, Paimon, please stop her! Sucrose and I agreed to present the wine ingredient to you together, but when she heard that Razor will be showing up, she insisted that she won't spend a moment longer here than she has to.
I'm not good at dealing with strangers. Anyway, as long as the ingredient gets into the right hands, that's all that matters.
Oh, that won't do. We worked on this together, and we should present it together. I can't take credit for what you did.
It's not about the credit.
Wait, so does this mean the Knights of Favonius' ingredient is a product of bioalchemy?
Yes, it's a quadruple sweetness sunsetia.
Quadruple sweetness? But aren't regular ones sweet enough as it is? Also, why a sunsetia?
Okay, let me give you the full story. I love the scent of wine, and after reading up on the art of winemaking, I've grasped some of the key principles. In short, whatever ingredients you use, it's essential to include something sweet.
Okay.
In an attempt to select the most suitable ingredient, I gathered samples of all the sweet plants and fruits I could find in the Mondstadt area. Then, I tried them all in turn and took detailed notes. I also factored in the differences between the same ingredient grown in different locations. For instance, sweet flowers from Springvale are a little sweeter than those at Cape Oath.
Wow, that sounds like a lot of work.
It was no problem at all. Just my duty as a maid of Favonius. The chance to source the Defender's will on behalf of the Knights of Favonius is a huge honor for me.
Noelle, your eyes are sparkling.
You're talking to Noelle, but you're looking at me.
But Paimon thinks it could be because of Lisa's brainwashing.
Anyway, I was worried that my evaluation would be too subjective if only I were involved. Thankfully, I ran into Sucrose the other day on her way out of the lab.
Oh no!
What is it, Sucrose?
I just remembered why I left the lab that day. I was supposed to go and fetch some lab equipment we imported recently.
Oh.
Uh-oh. That look on your face seems to say you forgot all about it and have been in the lab this whole time.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, I'm so sorry. Don't worry about it. It's my fault, really. I'll go and see Marjorie about the equipment shortly. Carry on, Noelle.
Oh, okay. Anyway, Sucrose is a true professional when it comes to this kind of research. I showed her my list, and she made some extremely valuable suggestions.
Please, you don't need to go out of your way to compliment me. Noelle filled me in on the background of the whole situation. I was moved to see how seriously she took this task, even though she'd never even met Razor before. However, none of the potential ingredients she had identified were perfect candidates, in my opinion. What we needed was a fruit high in sugar and easily fermentable. After a final look at Noelle's list, I picked a Sensetia sample from near Cider Lake as a basis, with a view to improving it.
She's driving me up the walls.
Using bioalchemical techniques, we were able to amplify the sweetness, then conduct a few tests to compare the results against the benchmarks.
Watching Sucrose work on an experiment when she's in the zone blew me away. Such focus and determination.
I already said don't compliment me. Anyway, the result of our research is the Epsilon series Tetrasweet Sensetia, Variation 63. And it's finally ready. The sweetness has been verified through rigorous testing. And the size and color are both optimal, too. Noelle shortened the name to Quadruple Sweetness Sensetia. Unfortunately, it can't be produced on a very large scale under the current conditions. Traveler, there's something else I'd like to share with you.
Can you just shut up? I really don't want to listen to you.
Growing up, I was lucky. I was never the best at dealing with other people, but my parents never placed any expectations on me. They never said to me, "You need to be more sociable," or anything like that. They just said, so I'm well aware that I'm one of the lucky ones. I haven't lived Razor's life, and I can't pretend to imagine what it must have been like. So I don't know how much it will mean coming from me, but...
Oh.
Sorry, I am late again. Teacher forgot about the time. Kept talking and talking.
That's all right. We were just chatting. Whoa, deja vu. Paimon said the exact same thing 2 days ago. Wait a sec. Where did Sucrose go?
Wow, she disappeared the moment he opened the door. Hello, I'm Noelle, maid of the Knights of Favonius.
Hi.
Here's our ingredient for you. Oh, but I can't take full credit for it. I had help from an alchemist, but right now... She... Right, yes. It's a shame she couldn't be here to present it to you in person.
Smells like potion, nectar, and Animo Crystal Fly, right?
Wow! Nothing gets past your nose, does it?
This Sunsetia is sweeter than ones I have smelled before. Klee said alchemy is amazing. It can make things better.
That's right. I hope that this sweet fruit will help you brew the sweetest wine.
Thank you all. When she has time, I want to thank her also.
Leave that to me. I'll figure out a way to persuade her to not work so hard all the time so that I can introduce you to each other.
Okay, I will wait.
All right, now that we have all the ingredients, we can finally start making the wine. For that, we'll need a barrel, which, if Paimon remembers correctly, is waiting for us at the Angel's Share stand.
What if I do, Luke?
Bye, Noelle! We're gonna head off now.
Good luck with everything. See you next time.
The whole story. So, this bright idea was the brainchild of you two? How could you? Razor is Daddy's friend, and he was a good influence, right up until you got him interested in wine. Razor, you better promise me that you won't turn into one of those old booze hounds that drinks themselves silly, slumps over the bar, and bursts into tears.
I don't understand.
Sounds like there's been some crossed wires here. Klee, what exactly did you say to Diona?
I told her that Razor's looking for his mommy with the Honorary Knight's help, and you both seemed really sad and said you needed some wine so maybe Diona could help. But before I finished, Diona said, "Klee, say no more! I'm getting involved in this if it's the last thing I do." And then we came here.
Okay. Paimon doesn't even know where to start. Diona, it sounds like Klee left out a few important details in the story. Let us set the record straight.
So you're saying Razor wants to make the same wine that his mother and father once made? So he can learn more about them? You better not be making this up to try to pull the wool over my eyes!
Sorry, Diona. It was all Klee's fault for not explaining it properly. So, are you still mad? Or can you help Razor make the wine? I caught a bunch of fish for us to eat. And you can pet Dodoko too if you want.
I wasn't that angry.
Yes, you were.
You're just trying to help. I understand. I just don't want Razor being led astray, that's all. That's why I may have raised my voice a little bit just now. Well, since none of you plan on drinking it, then I suppose I can help you just this once despite my reservations. But I need you to know that I'm a mixer, not a brewer. So I'm used to working with the finished product. If you really want me to start with a bunch of raw ingredients, that's fine. but I can't make any promises about how it'll turn out.
Yay! Diona is the best!
Bunch of flatterers. Now watch this. All done! That was quick! Now we just need to find a place to store it. We wait for a windier day. Does that mean we need to put it somewhere exposed to the wind?
Maybe Windrise? Very windy.
Yep, if you say the word windy, that's the first place on every Mondstadter's mind.
Cool! I want to come too.
I have to keep an eye on my foolish father, so I won't be joining you.
Good.
Klee, come and play again some other time.
I will, I promise.
Rain. If only it could cleanse the corrupt souls of this world.
Ah! What a curious coincidence meeting you here.
Don't get fired. What are you doing here?
Well, I awoke to the most magnificent aroma in the air. After following the sweet scent of fresh fruit to its source, this is where I ended up.
Yeah! The fruit are super fresh and super duper sweet! I can smell it as well!
Yes! Oh, I remembered something important. Something that you have to do before sealing the barrel and burying it in the ground.
What? We missed something?
Razor, do you still remember the scent of that half bottle of Thousand Wind wine? I believe there was a hint of bitterness in there.
Yes, there was.
And with very good reason, too. The source? This.
Dandelion seeds?
You're familiar with dandelion wine, right? Well, the people of Mondstadt believe that the wind can bring back the soul, and also preserve memories. Dandelion seeds are like living gemstones, formed from the first wisps of wind in the year. People add them to the mix at the last second as a way of capturing the wind in the very moment that the barrel is sealed. The memory of that moment is then stored in the wine for all time. So, Thousand Wind wine is the original dandelion wine.
Wow!
That's so cool! So now our story will be made into wine too!
As for why it always has a different scent, well, that's because people have the freedom to include whatever ingredients they want.
But is it, Razor? What you thinking about?
In Mother and Father's wine, I can smell dandelion seeds, but I don't know what else. In my wine, there is a lot of friendship. I still don't understand my mother and father, but I still have you and everyone else.
Yep.
Everyone has done so much for me. Farka, Teacher, Klee, Bennett, Uncle Brown Cat, Cold Lady, Grown Up with Fake Smile.
I think Grown Up with Fake Smile he means dealing. I don't know.
Gray Tough Girl, Person That Smells Like Animo Crystal Fly, Uncle Brown Cat's Daughter, Green Bard, Paimon, and Traveler. I remember everyone. Making wine is hard work. Making this wine needed everyone working together. Hard work with friends? Not so hard after all. I'm so happy. Thank you. Friends are also Lupikal. Whether I'm human or I'm wolf, it doesn't matter. From now on, all of us are together. When I grow up, we will come back here and we will open this wine together.
What a magnificent monologue. Even as a bard, I don't feel like there's anything else to add. All that remains now is to bury the barrel and wait for the fruit to ferment.
We're finally done! Paimon feels like a celebration is in order! If Paimon remembers correctly, tomorrow should be wind coming day, right?
Wow! The animal god is coming home!
That reminds me. I haven't memorized the song for the toasting ceremony yet. I'd better get back. Friends, I shall see you all tomorrow. Get a good night's sleep tonight. Wait for the whisper of the gentle breeze to rouse you tomorrow morning. Then come and enjoy a performance by the greatest bard to ever grace the streets of Mondstadt.
Well, since we're waiting for that.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember. But where are those who share the memory? Violet grass is a plant that enjoys a moist environment and is best picked after it rains. If you should choose to pick any, be sure to store them appropriately. My power is growing.
Oh, that's right. It's all the way there.
My name is Xiangling. I'm a chef from Liyue. Everything's ready. Let's...
I don't want to pull Sino, but I guess we'll give him a test run.
Judgment is upon you.
Hello. He's stronger than I thought.
Your penance is due! Guilty! Your penance is due! Through me, justice is served!
Oh, my
word. Your sins weigh upon your soul.
I don't know if it's hard as well, the master.
I'm used to it.
He is powerful. Okay, so we still have to wait. So, while we do that, let's go back to Liyue. Higher by 75.
Thank you.
Welcome, friend of child. And congratulations on the first day of your illustrious career with the Fatui. You sound remarkably sure of yourself. Remember, we are mere mortals. Our ideas are fluid like water. Only the Tsuritsa truly has a will as solid as the permafrost. But back to the matter at hand. Child tells me that he has upheld his end of your agreement.
What agreement? Oh, the thing about him helping us find a guy?
Correct. Child promised he would find someone to break the stalemate. And the Harbingers do not break their promises lightly.
Ah, where is that guy anyway?
Child is currently at Lioli Pavilion.
Oh, Paimon knows this one! Ahem. There are two styles of cooking in Liyue, known as Lee style and Yue style. They have been competing for centuries, but neither has emerged as the clear winner. The flagship restaurant of the Lee style is the Lioli Pavilion. The owner especially chose to open the restaurant at Feiyun Slope. Don't talk to Paimon like that! Anyway, Paimon's hungry. Let's get moving.
I don't want to find Child. He's gonna be right outside, isn't he?
Aha, you made it. As promised, I have found someone who can help you. Someone who can solve the mystery of why the Liyue Qixing would hide the Geo Archon's vessel.
So, where is he? In Lioli Pavilion?
He certainly is. Come, I'll introduce you. I took the liberty of setting up a business dinner, as per the Liyue custom.
This better be good. Wait.
Welcome back, sir. You honor us with your patronage. Mr. Zhongli is awaiting your arrival in the room.
I thought so. So I've had Zhongli since I started playing, and now we get to actually... Oh, it's quite a name. I realize that he and Zhao are the same thing.
Hi. Allow me to introduce Mr. Zhongli, consultant to an organization known as Wangsheng, and a trusted associate of the Fatui. Indeed, Wangsheng's line of work can be sensitive at times. Let's just say they understand when discretion is needed. And we, the Fatui, have always been glad to do business with friends who walk in the shadows.
Walk in the shadows?
It is an honor to meet you. I have heard tell of you from Mondstadt.
Of course you have.
Discretion? Shadows? Is Wangsheng some kind of business involving dealing with people?
Not that way, Paimon. Get it straight.
Indeed. It is as you have guessed. The Wangsheng Funeral Parlor organizes burials. We ensure that those who pass on do so in peace.
Huh?
Did you think he was some sort of hired killer?
Okay, the traveler's looking right at Zhongli and no one else.
The Fatui calls many such people friends, but the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor does not dabble in such business. Well, ostensibly. Well, they are still... I shouldn't say too much. In any case, I brought you to meet Mr. Zhongli because...
Because I can bring you to see Rex Lapis's vessel.
What?
Don't be so surprised. Sure, the Geo Archon's body has been squirreled away by order of the Tian Xuan Ning Guang. But first, let's hear what Mr. Zhengli has to say, shall we?
Rex Lapis may be the prime of Adepti, but he is ultimately an Adeptus. Many Adepti have left us over the millennia. This is the inexorable trend. The times have changed. You must have felt it too when you were at Jueyun Karst. As you have seen, the time of the Adepti is ending, and the time of mankind is slowly dawning. In years past, Liu's tradition was that a huge memorial service be held to mark the passing of every Adeptus. But this time, the Qixing have made no attempt whatsoever to respect this tradition. It is sacrilege.
Yeah, the killer hasn't even been caught yet.
He's sitting right beside you.
Deicide or not, the concern of the Wangsheng funeral parlor is this. When the ritual to receive this god is so kingly, it is all the more egregious for his final send-off to go unattended to. Traveler, Child has told me a lot about you. Since you have had dealings with the Animo Archon, could I ask you to help me prepare the Geo Archon's last rites?
A wise decision.
Why would I say no?
The Tianchuan Ning Guang has forbidden anyone from accessing Rex Lapis's vessel, which of course you would need to access if you were to achieve your goal of meeting all of the seven.
Precisely. Only by participating in the rite of parting will you be able to see the form of Rex Lapis again. If we are agreed, come with me. We will speak of the details as we walk.
All right, my bridge building work here is done. Turned out well, didn't it? You can go if you want to. Don't worry about me. I might just have a few more drinks and get acquainted with these things they call chopsticks in the meantime.
Good, you can stay there. It's so interesting meeting Zhao and Zhongli in like the same sort of time frame here.
After having experienced the land of the absentee Archon, Traveler, how does it feel to know that our Archon and Adepti are here all around you in Liyue? Indeed. The weight of 3,700 years worth of history runs deepest in the true divinity of Liyue. Organizing the rite of parting should prove to be an enlightening part of your travels. Liyue is the most prosperous of the seven nations, defended by deities and ruled by the Qixing. As such, the diplomatic maneuverings of the Fatui have gained no purchase here. Ning Guang of the Qixing has always been on her guard against the Fatui. That is in all likelihood why Child wants to make use of the Wangsheng funeral parlor's connections.
Huh. What would Child get out of us doing the rite of parting anyway?
I neither know nor do I wish to know. As far as I am concerned, the Fatui are merely financial sponsors. I only wish for Liyue's traditions to endure. These are the advance funds that Child has provided. If you use them up, you can go to him to apply for any subsequent funding.
Wow!
Well then, let us be off. The first step in our preparations shall be to obtain some prize Noctilucus jade worthy of a deity.
Welcome to the Jade Mystery, my good friends. Would you like to try your luck betting on Jade? This could be your lucky day. It's cheap and it's fun, and who knows, you just might strike it rich.
Betting? No, we're here for... what was it again?
Noctilucus Jade, of radiant grade at the very least.
Radiant grade, Noctilucus Jade? I see, you're not a tourist. My apologies. I have some here for your perusal. What do you think? The Jade Mystery is an old name in the jade business. Just look at that wonderful quality. Rex Lapis doesn't often bless us with such finery. Go on, pick whichever one you like.
These three pieces really do look pretty. Not like the ones you usually dig up. But how do we pick? Should we just grab one and go?
Oh? You want me to decide? That is fine as well.
It literally was an option to ask you. Hey, Kakashi. And hello to whoever else is watching, too. I'm good. I'm at a weird part in the game right now, my goodness. We have the event going on in Mondstadt. Got Liyue. We've met Zhao, and now we're with Zhongli. Did the test trial with Sino. Might actually have to try and pull for him now. A lot's happening. My night's good. What about yours?
If it were me, the answer would be simple.
Mm-hmm.
Oh? And that would be...
I'll take them all, boss.
Oh, you act with such panache, good sir. I always knew you were not a man of ordinary caliber.
Wait, boss! That one didn't count! We need to discuss it again!
Come on, shut up.
Hey! If we only need one for the ritual, are we wasting three times the Mora if we buy them all?
Oh, Mora. It is as you say. I suppose I overlooked this particular aspect of the transaction.
Huh? How do you not think about Mora when buying things?
If one must always consider Mora before acting, then in all things one is bound by Mora.
What?
All Mora is currency, but not all currency is Mora.
Is this how the rich live? Well, he knows a lot about big money, but not a lot about big savings.
Shut up. Nice.
No need to waver. Even when I am constrained by Mora, I have ways of working around my limitations.
He is a god, Paimon.
Evaluating the quality of Noctilucus Jade is indeed very tricky. As crude ore, there is little difference in texture, lustrousness, and internal pattern between good and bad jade. Only after the item made using Noctilucus Jade has taken shape will you be able to see whether it is up to par or not. If you return to those crafty merchants to quibble, they will counter by saying that your crafting bench is to blame, or that your heat control was poor.
Whoa! To think it's that easy to get cheated!
But there is a way to truly evaluate this jade, and a true insider would know it. A fool sees the pointer and misses the moon.
What does that mean?
If you point at the moon with your finger, a wise man knows that you are pointing at the moon, while a fool will only see the finger. The patterns, the facade, these are all the finger. Noctilucus Jade is a mystical stone used to light up the darkness, and so its brightness is the important thing. It is the moon. Noctilucus Jade of excellent quality would have superior pyro affinity. In other words, The bluer and brighter the luster of the ore under high temperature, the higher its quality. I have imparted the priceless secrets of the jade trade to you. Now, all that's left is to put it into practice.
Priceless, huh? Paimon's just said that we might never be able to use it again. We're back to buy some rocks, boss. But can you let us burn them first?
Burn them? You can't do that, my friends. If you were to do so, what would I have to sell? That would... Well, fine. As you wish, then. How about this? I can take a small sample of all three. I'll take a bit of a loss. We'll count it as a friendly gesture.
Don't worry. I know the rules. As long as we can prove that it is good jade, you will not take a loss.
All right, take these as samples. I've carved them off with a knife and tagged them to boot.
Aren't these too thin? Even paper's thicker. No, even a bug's wings are thicker. These are almost see-through.
Oh, you flattered me, but I have to be gentle with these rocks. They are my pride and joy. If I'd taken off even a bit more, it would have killed me.
But wouldn't something this thin go poof if we held it to the fire?
It can't be helped. Trying to deprive a merchant of his profits would be like forcing a ravenous wolf to vomit up the food in its stomach. Nonetheless, under the right conditions, these thin slices will serve.
What sort of conditions?
While we add the high temperatures using pyro, we can use hydro to reinforce it from within. This way, the samples will not disintegrate immediately.
Oh, sir, to think you were this learned. Thank you for your understanding.
Strictly speaking, asking for samples when we have not yet agreed to purchase the goods is unfair. Trade in Liyue must be based upon fairness.
Well, guess we just need to find a place to try this out. Oh, Paimon remembers? We once saw this big pot down at the Dadaupa Gorge in the camp of the Hilly Trolls from the Meaty Tribe. It's real sturdy and should be able to take the elemental reactions. Now, let's pack those samples up and make a move!
Yeah, Kakashi, I was looking for the treasure chest in Mondstadt earlier and sort of gave up because I couldn't remember where all they said they were.
It has been a long time since I last set foot in the Nation of Wind. A friend of mine from Mondstadt would always bring a few bottles of locally brewed dandelion wine whenever he came to visit me in Liyue. It must be said that the feigned liquor of the land of pastorals is far better than Sumeru's frigid snake wine.
Dang, I was trying to act like we were taking a walk with him. Oh, there it is. And of course, there's Hilly Trolls.
Trolls are still using it. It's a bit impolite, but we gotta cut the line.
Gather.
Yeah.
You guys have a go, Kyle?
Dodge this! Cool it! This moment will be frozen in time.
I will, when I can figure out how to get up there.
There's still soup in here! These hilly trolls sure have big appetites! This soup looks like it could be used as our hydro-elemental protection. Let's fire it up and begin our experiment! We're ready to go! Paimon will help remember which one of the three is which. Use Pyro to keep making the pot hotter until we get the results we need. Mr. Zhongli said that the shinier and bluer the ore gets, the better it is, so pay close attention. Wind-coming day is finally here! Let's get a move on or we'll miss the toasting ceremony! Whoa! That light came from the first note to Lucas Jade! Hilly trolls are surrounding us again! Were they attracted by the light? Such nosy neighbors! Let's take care of them and continue again after!
Order guide you! Stabilize! Solidify!
That light came from the second note to Lucas Jade, didn't it? More hilly trolls! They don't give up, do they? Looks like they're mad that we ruined their food!
Be gone!
Dodge this! Oh, so sorry. Freeze! Dodge this!
Windblade!
This is order.
retribution!
Oh, that's bright! Too bright! That was the third Noctilucas Jade, wasn't it? It was so much shinier than the rest. Let's go with that one. Let's head back to the Jade Mystery to buy some jade, shall we?
Okay, I guess that is as far as it wanted us to go.
Back, my friends. I've kept the goods for you. Which of them would you like?
Exactly! That's the one Paimon remembers, too!
I love how shyly it's just... He's there. Didn't... Okay. Just poof.
No problem. If you have your eye on this one, you can have it.
Then we'll take a box of the third type of jade.
Done. All the same, and pardon me for asking, but I'm curious. Whatever do you need this much top-quality Noctilucas jade for?
I suppose it would not hurt to tell you. We need them to make implements for the rite of parting.
Parting? Oh, dear. I'd heard the rumors, but had given much thought to them. This means that Rex Lapis really is... Oh, it's hard to believe. Even though the Jade Mystery has been in decline, we have always been under his protection. It is said that when our Lord lost his way while going incognito in the city 200 years ago, it was a spoon from the Jade Mystery that he had used to sample the local delights. Alas, alas, all things must pass. Well, if this is to be used to say farewell to Rex Lapis, then I shall sell this to you at half the price.
Are you sure? You didn't want to even give us an inch before.
If not for our Lord's protection, this city wouldn't exist as it does now. No proprietor could earn money off such a thing.
Oh, I'm sure Rex Lapis will feel your sentiment, boss.
You guys, he is standing right there with you.
In the safe hands of the Liu Achising and good, honest merchants such as yourself, I for one believe that Liyue will continue to prosper as it always has done.
All right. Thank you, my friends. What's with me getting all sentimental like this? I'll practically be giving away all my fortune at this rate.
Now that we've made our choice, let's take this Noctilucas jade back.
Hey, wait a minute. He said it was half price, not that we could leave without paying.
Oh, right. I'm sorry. I must have forgotten to do that, too. Let me see. As I thought, I didn't bring any.
Any what?
Mora. My apologies. Another oversight on my part.
Oh, that won't do. This is... That's a relief. Have a look.
It's fine. Just enough for half price. Though, to be honest, it'd be all right even if the sum wasn't quite enough.
Well, it's settled then. Let's take this jade to Yujing Terrace. That's where we plan to hold the rite.
Look at you bossing everyone around. You didn't cough up a single mora.
I will do my best. You have my thanks.
Huh, what are you?
We can leave the jade here. I have already called for a jewelsmith to shape them into the implements that we will need. Ah, yes. I have yet to go and see Child. So, as for the jewelsmith's remuneration...
Guess we can't do anything else. Also, is this where we're doing the rite of parting?
Yes. I have already rented this location, and have begun making preparations for the rite. That's right. The Liyue Qixing have acquiesced to using the same location.
But when something this big happened here, should suspects like us really be at the crime scene? We might get caught by the Millilith. Although with that said, since we got back from Dwayne Karst, none of those pesky Millilith soldiers have come chasing after us. Wonder what that's about. Also, the, Rex Lapis vessel...
Traditionally, we call it the Exuvia.
Ah, right! That's what it was called. You seem to know everything, Mr. Zhongli. So, was this Exuvia hidden away by the Qixing? I mean, we haven't even figured out who the murderer is.
One must think that they already have someone in mind. Or perhaps they already know. Surely they must have found all the evidence that there is to find here. These things are for the authorities in Yujing Terrace to consider. Trying to help would probably only add to their troubles. Before the rite is conducted, the Exuvia will be kept temporarily in the Golden House.
Golden House?
The only mint in Liyue, which is to say the only mint in Teyvat. All the mora that flows throughout the world is minted there.
Wow! Oh, no! Paimon wasn't thinking about anything bad. Paimon thinks it suits Morax. But why do you know this, Mr. Zhongli?
Since the rite of parting has the approval of the Qixing, it is a semi-official event. As such, there is already some limited information available. Perhaps each has their motives. But this is the capital of commerce. A little exploitation once in a while is not unacceptable. In Liyue, where the god of contracts reigns, only contracts may not be betrayed. I, for one, have no issue with little maneuvers outside their remit. Well then, we should go and prepare the perfumes used in the rite.
Perfumes? Where'll we get those? Do we buy them?
No. Perfumes used to honor the gods must be freshly decocted. The quality of the silk flowers we require is also special. Silk flower petals contain a fibrous material of good quality, often used in brocade making. Its scent, however, is most elegant, and is especially suited for solemn events, like giving offerings to gods and adepti.
It's time for Zhongli's lectures on high society again.
Hey, I don't mind. I'll listen to him all day.
We shall not speak of the details right now. Follow me. We shall go to the merchants to purchase our ingredients.
Thank you. my color. Join the Adventurer's Guild. You'll have a blast.
Senua Kiosk. Place to go for classic UA dishes.
Silk flowers? We certainly do. Which kind would you like?
Which kind? The good kind? The best kind? Remind Paimon what kinds there are again.
Ugh, you ignorant shoppers. Always coming in here with your stupid questions.
Golden House Maiden, Valley Weaver, and Fate's Yearning. One of each to start with, if you don't mind.
My goodness, this gentleman is quite the connoisseur. You two must be his servants. Please refrain from any further attempts to contribute. I'm sorry? Ah, yes. We've met before, haven't we? Sorry, traveler. I shouldn't have spoken to you in that tone. Now then, please peruse at your leisure. Do let me know if you have any further thoughts.
Silk flowers exhibit different properties based on how their environmental conditions differ from their ancestral habitat. Nevertheless, these are fine specimens, excellently preserved. Just look at the abundant foliage here, and these stamens, glamorous as a maiden of the Golden House. This strain is an evergreen, and mostly grows under complex hydrological conditions. By contrast, this variety thrives in any dark, damp location, often in large clusters. Morphologically, it is distinguished by the profusion of petals and densely packed stamens, though its powerful scent gives it away just as easily. Lastly, this strain is quite the recluse. Unlike its exuberant cousins, flowers and foliage are minimal. And when in season, it has a subtle yet enduring scent. It was first discovered by the ancients when they scaled the mountains in search of the Adepti. Silk flowers have all but disappeared from the wild today due to geographical changes over Liyue's history. Most are not grown by horticulturalists.
Wow! A true connoisseur! Most of that was news even to me.
I possess but a smattering of trivial knowledge. My traveler friend is the one to watch. They are on track to set foot in every corner of the world.
Oh, Mr. Zhongli, you're way too humble. So which silk flower did you want anyway?
I'll take them all, boss.
Again?
How can I put this? When purchasing opera tickets, it is natural to decide based on which singer has the most melodious voice. The same logic applies when purchasing a pet bird. But this silk flower purchase is not an analogous case. The same logic does not apply. Perhaps you don't know. Tradition states that we should decoct perfume from different subspecies of silk flower when making an offering to a statue of the Seven. Rex Lapis will then make his own choice between the scents. Like several other tedious and complicated traditions, this one has become simplified over time. But this is the only rite of parting to take place for one of the seven in 3,700 years. As such, I do think we should honor tradition down to the last detail in this case. Now that's settled, a question. Do you...
You forgot to bring money again? Zhongli...
If I may interject, did I hear you say that these flowers are to be an offering to the Lord of Geo himself?
Yes, in a sense.
Gosh, well, why didn't you say so? I heard the awful news about what happened at this year's Rite of Dissension. It would be bad luck to say it out loud, but I've been worried about our dear Lord ever since. I'm worried that everything I've heard is true. Since these flowers will be used to glorify our Lord, they're free of charge. Just don't forget to pass on my regards.
Are you serious?
Why wouldn't I be? I would be nobody if not for Rex Lapis. If he hadn't written those poems in praise of my wares, they'd only be worth a fraction of what I can sell them for today.
Huh. So much folklore here revolves around Liyue's deity making cameo appearances in support of local businesses.
Thank you, boss. I think I speak for all of us when I say that your generosity has saved our skins.
Our skins? You were the one who forgot to bring money!
Please, it's the least I could do.
So, now that we've got the flowers, how do we make the perfume?
Ideally, with the help of an expert. Unfortunately, none of my acquaintances have personal experience in the art of decoction.
Talk about first world problems.
Hence, I need you to help by asking around in the city. Try the common folk, especially women.
So this time we get to go around town looking for nice smelling ladies to talk to? Paimon likes this job.
I will wait for you near the Statue of the Seven. Meet me there when the perfume is ready.
Maybe we can find some good candidates at the Adventurers Guild. Let's ask Lan! She's master of the Liyue branch, right?
I stopped accepting commissions a long time ago. Sorry, you two, but you'll just have to ask another adventurer.
Oh, it's not that kind of favor. It's just a teeny tiny thing.
Wow. Just wow. Do I look like the kind of girl who wears perfume to you? I think you're underestimating the kind of person I am.
Well, Paimon thinks you smell amazing. So come on, Lan. What's your secret, if not perfume?
Now that you mention it, yes, there is something. What is that scent? Oh, it must be from the Qingxing flowers I picked on the way back. I forgot I still had them with me.
Aha! The truth is out. Lan's got a soft spot for wildflowers.
No. They were for medicinal use only. Anyway, this is a pointless conversation. If you want to know about perfume, try talking to Qimei.
The fortune teller, right? Paimon remembers she smells pretty good. Thanks, Lan. See you around.
Should I save this money or invest it?
How may I help?
We've come to ask you a question.
Perfume? I rarely think to use it, let alone about how to make it myself. That said, some of the cosmetics I use are scented. Perhaps that's the cause of this confusion. Since I usually set up my stall by the docks, I avoid perfume like the plague, because Celestia forbid those lusty sailors catch a whiff and come hunting for the source.
That's the worst thing Paimon's heard all day!
While we're on the subject, have you never heard anyone mention Ying'er's homemade perfume?
Ying'er? Oh, as in scent of spring Ying'er?
Yes, that's her. Many a rich family's daughter has gotten her to make perfume for them. Apparently, her homemade product is better than anything you'll find on the market.
Great! This is just the intel we need! Finally, we're getting somewhere!
I have a feeling she'll be hard to find. Or not.
Well, hello. You found me at last. I've been waiting for you.
What? How did you know we were coming?
Oh, I heard a rumor about a couple who were snooping around town looking for a sweet-smelling lady. Actually, I was starting to worry you wouldn't find me. This is the ultimate test of my appeal, after all.
Snooping around? Why are you making it out like we're bad people?
What can I say? People love to talk. Maybe you ought to be more discreet in the future if you don't want word to get around. Relax. I know why you're here. You want to get your hand on my homemade perfume, don't you? What kind would you like? 3-in-1 go. My goodness. You have extreme tastes for someone your age. Maybe the rumors I heard were true after all. You're on the prowl and need some sweet-smelling ammunition. Is that it? Is that the best you could come up with? Even if you were genuinely offering perfume to a deity, that doesn't explain why you'd need 3 kinds. Sorry, your story just doesn't hold water.
Zhongli was right. People don't remember this tradition anymore.
As one of my favorite poems goes, O cherry tree, begrudge not thy blossoms as they are deflowered in the spring, for come winter, even thy sturdiest wood shall wither.
That went over Paimon's head a little.
In short, I'm happy to help. Traveler, you can be my assistant, but you'd better make sure I'm the only person on your mind while you're hanging around with me. So, where is a good place for making sweet, sweet perfume? Where is that, Mondstadt? We're only making some perfume. There's no need to go to such ridiculous lengths. Somewhere closer to home will do. Let's go for the kitchen at Wan Min Restaurant.
Adventurer,
I've had a word with Chef Mao. We can start work now. Are you ready to please me?
What did you say?
I meant make me proud, as my assistant, obviously. While I'm setting up, you can go and fetch some water.
Liyue people must have iron stomachs.
Try something new at the Wanmen restaurant.
May have overeaten.
People must have iron stomachs.
Oh, I think I may have overeaten.
This water will do nicely. Now, I need you to extract the silk flower essence using a crafting bench. Perfume making uses an altogether different technique from alchemy. Here, let me teach you. Very carefully, take hold of the mortar and pestle. Gently does it. You need to keep your wrist firm so your hand doesn't slip. Now use your strong hand to stir it with a persistent rhythm. Keep going until the juices start to come out. Ooh, you're a natural, like a fish to water. Now take these and try it out on your own using a nearby crafting bench. Don't forget to do all three. They look visually identical during the essence extraction process, but I will put them into separate containers when the perfume is ready.
I guess I think we might do a wish or two and then I'll be done for the night. I'm done for tonight. I'll get back on tomorrow and we'll continue.